Your ex-husband, Matthew Badger, has said in interviews, and he's been very honest about this, that he was so grief-stricken and enraged that at one stage he wanted to kill you, kill your boyfriend, do whatever he could to try and, you know... But I know that you now have a pretty good relationship with him, I think.
Yes.
Tell me about that, because it's obviously very, you know, for him, as awful as it's been for you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I would imagine that if I were in Matthew's shoes, I would have had the exact same reaction. So I don't at all judge his grief or what he has chosen, you know, to say or do or feel. I mean, it's such mind-bending grief, you know. And I hope no one judges me.
You said at the funerals for your girls, you gave a eulogy and you put your hand on your heart. You said, "My girls are in my heart. They are right here. This is where they live now." Mm-hmm. Is that how you feel now?
Yes. And at one of the places, I had a dream, and on my way to Arkansas, and in my dream, Lily came to me, and she did it with fingers, and she said, "Mommy, I'm right there. I'm right there in your heart. Don't worry. I love you, Mommy." And then, you know, Sarah came to me, and when I was, you know, flipping out, and said, you know, "Don't worry, Mommy. There's nothing to be afraid of." And then I had a dream with Sarah where she also said, "Just look into my eyes. It's all okay." Mm. And then with Gracie, I see butterflies everywhere. And I know it's Grace. And, you know, they'll be in, if it's cold, if it's raining, wherever. And so I, you know, not only do I know that they're in my heart, but I know they're now that their presence is everywhere. And when all of those things were happening, I thought, wow, I am delusional. You know, this, I must be really nuts. You know, this must be what's happening to me. And, you know, actually, I read a book about a month ago called Proof of Heaven by Dr. Evan Alexander. And he's a neurosurgeon who was in a 7-day coma and had a near-death experience. And during that entire time, he was on the wings of a butterfly. He went to heaven on the wings of a butterfly. The messages are love. There's nothing to be afraid of, and you can't do anything wrong. And that dreams are more real than this life. And that's what Dr. Alexander said, and that's what Sarah had told me, you know, in June. And I read this book in November. And so when I read that book and I had that realization that this was real, I had what I think the saints call ecstasy, that moment of ecstasy when you really know God. You really know that it's real, that eternal life is real. And I had that feeling. It was amazing. And ever since then, I've felt so much at peace because I know with every fiber of my being that my girls are okay.
How will you spend Christmas? It'll be a year on. Normally such a happy day, a family day. For you, it's going to be an excruciatingly painful day. Where will you be? What will you do, do you think?
Every day has been awful. And there have been all sorts of, you know, they talk about when parents lose a child, that the first year anniversary of everything is really hard. Their birthday, you know, I had two because, you know, Sarah and Gracie are twins. But, you know, Mother's Day, Easter, Halloween, Thanksgiving. So, yes, you know, this is the day. And I'm certainly nervous about it. But because I've had all these other days, I kind of have a little bit of an idea of what to expect. And the truth is that the lead up to the actual day is much harder than the day itself. And so especially Lily's birthday was the first one that came. And I was terrified. I mean, I didn't sleep for days, and I was terrified. I couldn't sleep by myself. It was, you know, Kate. I had to go and stay at Kate and Jess's house again. And then I woke up on Lily's birthday, and the first thought that came into my head was, "I love you, Lily. Happy birthday." And I, you know, dressed up for her, and I, you know, put makeup on for her, and I just walked around all day, you know, saying happy birthday and I love you. And so I'm going to spend Christmas that way. And I'm going to go to Thailand. because, you know, I'm not Santa Claus is not really, you know, a happening thing for me right now. And there's an orphanage there, and these young girls, I mean, there are orphanages everywhere, but this one, these young girls are have lost their families. And so I'm going to take them suitcases filled with toys that I was able to get out of my garage. So that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to ride on elephants, I hope.
Madonna, it's a heartbreaking story. I just don't know how you got through this. Your courage is inspiring. I think that the way you talk about the girls is extraordinary. Mm. And I wish I could do something to ease your pain, but I can't. But I really appreciate you coming in today.
Thank you
for having me. I hope that Christmas isn't too unbearable.
Thank you.
You've got everybody with you.
Thank you.